Good morning, children. Welcome to online class. 8th standard first language English. Lesson number 18. Supplementary reader. The broken gate. This is written by Emmett Blyton. This is taken from Fun Time Tales. Emmett Blyton was a lifetime 1897 to 1968. She wrote over 600 books in her lifetime and is one of the world's favorite writers for children. This story, The Broken Gate, answers how the honesty of a young boy helps him to overcome the challenge and gains the trust of Mr. Twinkle. Now going through the lesson. Old Man Twinkle wanted a boy to help him in his shop. He needed a boy who could drive Jenny the pony, for all Twinkle's goods were taken round in the cart. So the old man Twinkle put a notice in his window, wanted boy to help after school hours. That is, old man Twinkle wanted a boy to help him in his shop. He needed a boy who could drive Jenny. So this is a pony, that is a small horse, to carry his goods round in the cart. So he put a notice in his window, wanted boy to help after school hours. Second para, all the boys saw the notice and many of them thought they would try for the job. They could do it after school and on Saturdays, and it would be a good job for old man Twinkle, because Twinkle was generous and kind. All the boys saw the notice and thought they could do the job after school and also on Saturdays. Why? Moreover, Mr. Twinkle was very generous and kind. Third para, that evening, all the boys, George, Henry, Peter, and Harry, went to see old man Twinkle. And Jack, who was called the smallest by his friends and who hesitated to try for the job because of his ragged clothes, also went to see who would get the job. Old man Twinkle wasn't ready to see anyone for the moment, so he told the boys to play in the yard till he called them. So that evening, all the boys, George, Henry, Peter, and Harry, went to see him, and Jack was the smallest among his friends. He hesitated to go with them because of his ragged clothes, but he went to see who would get the job, and the old man was busy, so he asked the boys to play in the yard till he called them. Seeing an enormous yard gate swinging to and fro in the wind, all the five boys climbed up on the gate. They shouted and pretended to whip the gate to make it gallop. It swung to and fro, and the boys shouted with delight. And then suddenly something happened. The gate was old and was not meant to carry five heavy boys. It broke away at the hinges, and the boys found themselves sliding off. The gate gave a groan and hung all crooked, swinging in a very peculiar manner. So what is the fourth press telling? The boys saw an enormous yard gate swinging to and fro in the wind. So all the boys climbed up on the gate and they shouted and pretended to whip the gate to make it a gallop. But the old gate, which could not bear their weight, broke away at the hinges. And the boys found themselves sliding off the gate, and the gate gave a groan and hung all crooked. Fifth para telling, all the boys thought that old man Twinkle was a at the front of the shop and he could not see what had happened. So the boys thought the old man Twinkle would not have seen what had happened to the gate. Then sixth, but we ought to tell him, said Jack. It's rather cowardly not to. My mother says we always ought to own up at once when anything is broken. Can we all five go and tell him? So the boy, Jack, he wanted to tell the old man what had happened because his mother advised him to own up at once when anything gets broken. No, said others. You might say he won't give any of us the job if we have done a thing like that. We won't say a word. So all the boys refused to do so because they decided not to utter a word about the broken gate because they won't get that job. At this moment, they saw Mr. Twinkle shouting at them, so they all went to him. Mr. Twinkle called them for an interview. Twinkle interviewed them one by one and he asked them some questions and also asked whether they knew anything about the broken gate. Surprisingly, all the boys pretended not to be knowing anything about the broken gate. So Twinkle interviewed them one by one and he asked some questions on his lesson. He asked about the broken gate also, but what a surprisingly, all the boys did not utter not in a single word about the broken gate. Mr. Twinkle told he would make his choice that evening. So they all went off except Jack, and he was worried about the broken gate. It was dreadful to break a thing and not to tell about it and not even try and mend it. He wondered if he could mend it. He swung the gate a little to see how much it was broken. So Twinkle, he told that he would give the result when in the evening. But all the other person left the place except Miss Jack, the boy, because he felt bad about the broken gate and also not telling about it to Mr. Twinkle and also for not trying to mend it as his mother advised him. He wanted to mend the gate. So whether he could do anything to the gate to repair it. So he swung the gate a little to see how much it is broken. Old man Twinkle saw Jack from the window and he called him in. Are you another boy after this job? He asked. Old man Twinkle saw Jack from the window and asked whether he was after the job. Jack, no, sir, said Jack. I am too small and not very clever. And I'm a bit ragged too because my mother hasn't much money. So Jack replied that he was very small and not clever enough. So he was wearing ragged cloth also because his mother had no money to buy. Said old man Twinkle, I see. Well, what are you doing out there in my yard? Do you know anything about that broken gate? Old man Twinkle asked him if he knew anything about that gate. Oh dear, thought Jack. Now what am I to say? I don't want to get the other boys into trouble. So Jack felt very sorry then because he didn't want to reveal and he didn't want to tell about his friends. Then so what he said? When he asked, do you know anything about the broken gate, he felt, but he said, that he knew that they only broke the gate. Oh dear, now what I want to get other boys in trouble. He went red and then he said, yes, Mr. Twinkle, I do know about that gate. What do you know about it? Asked the old man. I was singing on it when it broke, said Jack bravely, though he didn't feel at all brave, for Twinkle was frowning. And he said he knew about the gate. When he asked again, what do you know about the gate? Then, because he was in anger, and even though Jack replied bravely, but he was a little afraid on seeing a old man's anger. Then, oh, that is your weight. That is only, that is because of the weight only, what happened? That gate broken. Well, not too exactly. What do you mean, not too exactly? Oh, please, sir, don't be angry. But you see, some other boys and I were all swinging together on it, and it broke. Said Jack, I wanted to come and then tell you, really I did, but the others said no. And I couldn't give them away, could I? I stayed to see if I could mend the gate. That's what I was doing out in your yard. So what he said? Because he requested him not to get angry. When all the boys, they were all singing together, it broke. So he wanted to tell it, but they refused. So he did not want to, tell about his friends. So because he had to mend it, he was staying there to see what had happened to the gate. And whether he could mend the gate or not, then he was looking. I see, said the old man Twinkle, and he didn't look quite so fierce now. Well, who were the other boys? Don't be angry with me, Mr. Twinkle, but I really can't tell tales, said poor Jack. They are my friends, you see, and I don't want them to get into trouble. So for that again, Mr. Twinkle asked about who are the boys. Then, but Jack was not ready to tell the names of the boys because he didn't want them to get into trouble. Quite so, said old man Twinkle. And now I'm going to tell you something. The boys' names were Harry, Peter, George, and Henry. You see, I know them. And he, surprisingly, Mr. Twinkle told the names of the boys. But, oh, Mr. Twinkle, then... then that is a carried Jack. But why do you choose a boy that is... Sorry. Oh, said Jack, and then he started Mr. Twinkle again. Well, please choose one of the boys, he said. They are nice boys, really. Although they didn't own up about the gate. So again, he requested Jack to select one boy because they were all very good boys. And I have chosen my boy. Mr. Twinkle said, then he had already selected. Who is he? He is you only, Mr. Twinkle. Yes, I know you are small, but you will grow, especially if Mrs. Twinkle makes you putting every night. And I know you are at the bottom of the class for lots of things, but good food will make your brain grow too. And I know you are a bit ragged, but a little pocket money will buy you better clothes. So Mr. Twinkle said that he had selected already Jack only because of a poor food that he was small. Then if Mrs. Twinkle know, then makes pudding, then he gives him pudding every night, then he would grow well and naturally what happened, his brain also would then develop. So and because of the pocket money what he is given, he will buy good clothes also, no problem. Oh, Mr. Twinkle, then he carried back. But why do you choose a boy like me? The others are bigger and cleverer. Then Jack was surprised and he asked, why did he select? That is Jack when he had other boys or other and bigger and cleverer boys than him. Then they may be, said Mr. Twinkle, but what I want is a boy who is brave enough to own up when things go wrong. And I want a boy who can speak the truth, and I want a boy who is loyal. And if you are loyal to your friends, as you have been just now, you will be loyal to me too. I have chosen the right boy, Jack. Then I have chosen the right boy. So Mr. Twinkle told the reason why he selected Jack, because he was sincere and he was really brave enough to face any problem. And that is, he was brave to face the truth also. And he was loyal to his friends, not letting any one of names. And so he was loyal to his friends and he thought that he would remain loyal to him also. So he chosen the right boy. And so he had for Jack with himself, but not as an errand boy. Oh no, he is the head of the shop now. and doing very well indeed, all because of a broken hip. Wasn't it strange? So now Jack is not an errand boy, that is not the ragged clothes. Now he is the head of the shop. And then what? Why? Because of the broken gate only. So thanks to the broken gate. Isn't that strange? That is, broken gate has given him a good position. So that is, the people now often talk of achieving their demands by hook or crook. Such an attitude has never produced any good result. If anybody makes great fortune by foul means, then he will be ruined only. And a man must always be honest. That's what those boys didn't want to tell about the broken gate to Mr. Twinkle, but Jack was ready to tell all truth to him. So a man must always be honest. Honesty is the best policy. He will never get grief. Honesty may have its trials and challenges, but it's sure to succeed in the end. So that's how then Jack became the head of the shop, as he then fixed it to the truth and the honesty. Good children, we had a very good story.